Hey everybody, Dr. Cranky back in the laboratory. I wanted to answer a question that I get quite often. And so I'm going to answer it here and walk you through some of the discussion pertaining to the pros and cons of the paint system you use. Initially, I went out and I got both Tamiya Pure White and Tamiya Coral Blue. They're both still very new in the can. I love these colors. Tamiya has a great line of pastel 50s paints. And I thought, you know, it'd be good to start there and work from there. But instead, I ended up mixing my own colors and going with acrylic paint. And I'll tell you why. It's not that you cannot do it with this paint system, you know. It's just that you're adding a little bit more of a struggle to the whole process. Okay, I knew early on that I was going to do a foundation of rust and I was going to use salt. And there is something magical that happens when you put water on the vehicle, you sprinkle the salt, you dry it with a hair dryer, and then, you know, it dries powdery, chalky, and then you start layering in the colors. And for myself, I like to have the control of using the airbrush and of also being able to thin my paint and also be able to use transparent colors by mixing a little bit of airbrush medium, and also to be able to use certain filters. Sometimes I will link the color a little bit, dilute it to the level and consistency of ink, and I'm able to apply a variety of the color. You see it there a little bit with some of the color coming through. And so I just like, you know, when I'm doing a build like this, I really like the control of the airbrush and the techniques I've learned to use and love. And it doesn't mean that you can't do it with this, you know, with a different paint system. It just means that it's going to be a little bit more difficult, and sometimes not only difficult to remove the salt, but also difficult to handle the effect that you're after. My advice is, and I've done this before, you use these colors and then you come back in and apply the layers of weathering on top of that. But I like to begin from, you know, dark to light, and meaning, you know, the rust foundation, and move forward and outward from that. So you know, you can get very good effects. You could also sand down. You can use this system and then sand down through the layers, and I've seen plenty of great work done that way. So I just wanted to say that there isn't anything wrong with either method. It's just that eventually you get to the point where you enjoy one particular method slightly better than the other, and you know, you find your way. All right, so we're hoping that this helps and keeps you inspired. We'll be back with more Cranky Show. Stay tuned in.